Pain. Agony. My hatred burns through the cavernous deeps. The world heaves with my torment. Its wretched kingdoms quake beneath my rage. But at last, the whole of Azeroth will break, and all will burn beneath the shadow of my wings. Deathwing. Neltharion, also known as Deathwing, was originally the mighty Black Worm, chosen by the Titan Khazgroth to be one of the five dragon aspects, with domain over the earth and the deep places of the world. He was chosen as the caretaker of the continents of Azeroth, and he used his power to forge mountains and rivers for the benefit of mortal races. In peaceful times, Neltharion was renowned for his wisdom and power, and he became known as Neltharion the Earth Warder, a great protector of the land. Malagos, a spellweaver, the aspect of magic, was his closest friend. Then came the madness that destroyed Neltharion's mind, changing him and his kind forever, leading to the creation of the powerful item known as the Dragon Soul, later the Demon Soul. The inner voices of the old gods convinced him that he could have power beyond his imagination if he served them. The voices made him paranoid of even his own black dragonflight. Neltharion began to yearn for a world dominated by his black dragonflight, a world in which all the other dragonflights ceased to exist and Ysera and Alexstrasza would be his petty slaves for mating. The old gods convinced Neltharion to create the Dragon Soul. With the help of goblins, Neltharion created a simple golden disc made of his own blood and forged in the goblins' cauldrons and anvils deep beneath the earth. Empowered by Neltharion's magic, the simple disc was magically shielded so that the other dragon aspects could not see within it. There was an evil within the disc, some taint of the old gods, though what exactly is not known. When the Burning Legion entered Azeroth during the War of the Ancients, Neltharion saw the opportunity to complete his Dragon Soul. Guided by the voices of the old gods, he first captured demons of the Burning Legion and added their power to the Dragon Soul. Neltharion then convinced Malagos to help him with the other dragon aspects. All of them agreed to give a portion of their power to the Dragon Soul, including all dragons of their dragonflights. Neltharion proposed that the Dragon Soul disc could be a weapon of great power to destroy the demons of the Burning Legion. Unknown to the rest, Neltharion was the only one who did not give his power to the Dragon Soul. Neltharion, the dragon aspects, and their dragonflights flew towards Zinajari, where the Night Elves held the demons at bay. The dragons awaited Neltharion's first attack. He grabbed the Dragon Soul and by channeling his destructive power through it, destroyed thousands of demons with one swing of radiant magic. The dragon aspects watched in horror as Neltharion also killed hundreds of Night Elves and other allies along with the demons. Neltharion revealed the depths of his betrayal at last. Now with the disc at his command, he wanted all races and demons to see his power and bow to him. Dragon aspects attacked Neltharion in an attempt to take the Dragon Soul from him and to reason with him in hopes of determining the cause of his betrayal. The next swing of the Dragon Soul paralyzed all dragon flights and the dragon aspects in midair, rendering them unable to move or speak. Neltharion then struck out at the dragon aspects and their dragon flights, destroying many and scattering them far across the land. Neltharion's betrayal struck a great blow to the aspects, and their fear of being destroyed like the blue dragonflight kept them in seclusion. In desperation, the aspects shielded themselves and hid, to become undetected even by each other. The growing corruption in Neltharion's heart warped his body, as the angelic dragon began taking a more demonic appearance. Similar to how Sargeras changed to a more demonic form after his corruption, Neltharion's body cracked open, revealing his molten heart, and magma and fire flowed from his chest. His eyes became aflame in red, demonstrating the magnitude of his power and the depths of his evil. Thus was Deathwing the Destroyer born, and the Dragon Soul was renamed the Demon Soul. Deathwing returned to his lair beneath a mountain. His proximity to the demon souls ripping his body apart, so the goblin smiths forged an armor of adamantium to serve as a vessel to contain Deathwing's raging power and to keep them in check. Only the adamantium plates kept the power from destroying his body. The old gods had manipulated Deathwing into creating the demon soul, but their true intention was that the demons would inform their lord Sargeras of the great power of the weapon used against them. Sargeras would no doubt want the demon soul to power the gateway and to let them into Azeroth. By using the demon soul to amplify the gateway, the three old gods hoped to escape their prison beneath the planet. However, Malfurion Stormrage used the Emerald Dream to find Deathwing's lair and stole the demon soul from the Black Dragon, who tried to pursue the thief in vain. Illidan and Varathan captured Malfurion and took the demon soul back to Zinajari, to Manaroth the Destructor, the general of the Legion's armies. It was used to power up the portal that would allow Sargeras to enter Azeroth. Deathwing tried one last time to recover the disc when it was being used by both Sargeras and the old gods, and actually succeeded in reaching it. Deathwing was almost destroyed in the attempt, but after he got the demon soul, an enormous surge of power made him lose his grip on the disc and send him spiraling far away from the portal. After the Burning Legion was defeated, the Dragon Aspects sealed the Demon Soul with their energy, so that Deathwing should never be able to manipulate the Demon Soul. The artifact was hidden in an undisclosed location by Malfurion at the request of the Dragon Aspect. No longer in possession of the artifact and now unable to use it, Deathwing vowed to destroy most life and to wreak havoc on the planet. With his powers over Earth, Neltharion caused volcanoes to rise along with the destruction already caused by the Well of Eternity's implosion, sinking most of Kalimdor below the ocean. When he succumbed, Neltharion ceased to exist, taking up a new name and a bitter purpose. He became Deathwing. and his subjects were placed beneath the iron rule of a tyrant. Upon his irrevocable shift to evil, he turned against his destiny, and his mind unwound, causing suffering wherever he could. He himself chose Deathwing as his title, to better show his contempt and intentions for the lesser creatures around him. Certain legends surrounding Deathwing claim that as the Earth Warrior, Deathwing shaped the land so the races would not go to war over land and resources. When he went mad, Deathwing lowered the mountains and allowed the races to intermingle. He ruined fertile lands and destroyed other terrain so that the races would be forced to fight for food. Deathwing's efforts gave birth to an occupation that has remained with all the races since then, war. 10,000 years later, during the Second War, Deathwing discovered the Demon Soul's location. Although he couldn't wield its power because of the enchantment placed upon it by the Dragon Aspects, he realized that he could manipulate someone else to do so. Eventually, he found the perfect pawns, the orcs of the Dragonmaw clan. Through visions, Deathwing led the chieftain of the clan, Suluhed the Whacked, to find the Demon Soul. Suluhed, in turn, gave the Demon Soul to the warlock Necros Skullcrusher. Necros had no clue as to the power he was wielding, but was able to tap into enough of its power to capture and enslave Alexstrasza and her consorts in order to breed dragons for the Horde. Krill, a goblin servant of Deathwing, was sent to infiltrate the Dragonmaw clan and to serve Necros Skullcrusher. Necros ended up being manipulated by Krill into doing Deathwing's bidding. The goblin served as an advisor to Necros, whispering ideas to the orc in order to further Deathwing's aims. After Ner'zhul reopened the portal to Azeroth, his forces were approached by Deathwing. He offered his own children for assistance in exchange for a safe passage to Draenor. They agreed, and Deathwing helped them prepare for several key battles to steal two artifacts from the Alliance in order for Ner'zhul's newly reformed horde to create new portals to the other worlds. They then fled back to the dark portal to Draenor. Deathwing believed the world would be a relatively safe haven for his offspring and secreted away a cache of black dragon eggs there. While at his great mountain lair, he was attacked by the forces of the Alliance expedition, who destroyed several of his eggs. Deathwing was temporarily defeated, but survived. Having escaped back to Azeroth, Deathwing ended up in a fight with some of the Archmages of Dalaran and feigned defeat, falling into the sea where most of the council assumed at the time that he died. However, he wasn't dead, and he took a human guise, pretending to be a heroic noble named Lord Prestor in an effort to be declared King of Alterac, where he could manipulate the Alliance from within. Soon after Ner'zhul recklessly opened multiple portals on Draenor, the magical stress tore the planet apart. The energies released in this catastrophe altered Deathwing's eggs, resulting in the Nether Drakes, partially corporeal and partially ethereal, dragons who possessed the ability to shift between astral and physical planes. Without Deathwing's guidance, these otherworldly nether drakes are now just finding their own way among the blasted ruins of Outland. Deathwing, posing as Lord Prestor, managed to make himself popular with King Terranus and the kings of the Alliance nations, and for a while had a strong influence in the decisions of state. Using subtle magic, he was able to ensnare the minds of the human leaders and force them to grant him the title of King of Alterac. He also managed to trick King Terranus into giving him the hand of his daughter, Caelia Menethil. His ultimate goal was to obtain a high level of power and influence within the Alliance, so that he could destroy it from within. Deathwing began his campaign against the Alliance by pitting the kingdoms of Lordaeron, Stormguard, Gilneas, and Kul'Thras against the Cairn Tor of Dalaran, who Deathwing considered threats to his new identity. The only one to ever fully uncover the truth about his identity was the Dragon Mage Crassus, the mortal form of Corialstrath. However, the Cairn Tor were able to discern that he was a powerful being hiding in a human form and tried to devise a way to stop him. The orcs of the Dragonmaw clan at Grimbatol kept their hold over Alexstrasza, even though the bulk of the horde had already been defeated. Deathwing tried to frighten the Dragonmaw orcs into believing that the humans were attacking Grimbatol so that they would move Alexstrasza and her eggs north to Dunal Gaz. This left her eggs vulnerable. Deathwing hoped to steal Alexstrasza's latest cache for himself to create a new dragonflight. Though bearing the crimson scales of the Dragon Queen, they would be raised by Deathwing and carry his hatred for the mortal races. Deathwing used his pawns to manipulate the mage Ronan, who had been sent to Grimbatol by Crassus, as a part of a plan to free Alexstrasza. He saved the young mage several times and helped him reach Grimbatol, hoping that his appearance inside the mountain fortress would further convince Necros to flee from it. Though the orcs were convinced and began leaving Grimbatol, Deathwing's attack on the caravan, however, failed. Necros tried to use the Demon Soul on Deathwing, but he was unsuccessful due to the disc having no power of the Black Dragon. He then sent Tyrannostras, old and sick, to stop Deathwing, but he failed and was killed. At the behest of Crassus, the three remaining free aspects, Malagos, Ysera, and Nosdormu, grudgingly decided to come out of their lairs and attack Deathwing. However, due to the power they had given to the Demon Soul, they were no match to the Black Leviathan. But Ronan was able to steal the Demon Soul from Necros, freeing Alexstrasza in the process. Furthermore, he discovered its weakness and destroyed it, releasing all the powers of the dragons who had given their power 10,000 years ago. Deathwing was sent retreating with four very angry, fully empowered dragon aspects on his heels, though he managed to elude them in the end. Lord Prester vanished when Deathwing was forced to go into hiding, and Deathwing's influence over the nobles disappeared along with him. The Heroes of Azeroth, the millions of players, followed Deathwing, and after making his final stand against the heroes and fellow dragon aspects who stood in his way, the final blow to the destroyer was delivered by Thrall with the power of the Dragon Soul. As Deathwing's distorted body submerges into the maelstrom, his reign of destruction was finally brought to an end. After his death, the world relished in relief as they survived the cataclysm brought on by Deathwing, and the great purpose of the aspects was finally fulfilled, their ancient power being expended as they looked to the mortals to foresee a new age. And that is the story of Neltharion, also known as Deathwing. If you like this video, or like what I try to do here on this channel, consider subscribing. I'm sure I'll pop up in your home feed every now and then if you do. And leave a like if you want to. It gives me an idea of how well received this specific video was, and as a bonus, it helps me reach new people too. If you didn't enjoy the video, then feel free to leave a dislike. If you have any ideas or suggestions for other video topics, leave them in the comments down below. I'll be sure to read them all and totally not steal those ideas for another video. That's all for now, and thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one.